Like how you stroke the mic off.
Intro is playing.
You like how I stopped almost immediately?
Can we rewind section one, please? 15 seconds in.
Hey, we're live, boys. Be appropriate.
Yeah. Is the music playing?
The music is playing and the music is done. What is going on?
Oh. Hello, boss man. Hello, Forbes.
Hello.
How we doing, Land Geek Nation?
We'll be doing better in a second.
Whoa. 30 seconds in and we're stumbling over words.
All right. Well, you know, it is the nightcap.
It is the nightcap, yes.
So it's wonderful to be here. I think, if anybody's brand new, you're going to see a lot of, we're going to have a lot of fun, but we're going to have some content, and we're going to have more fun, then we have content. There might be like 3-1, fun to content, or content to fun. We'll see. But hang around. It's great. We'd like to talk about land investing. We'd like to have a couple of drinks. We keep it real. We keep it honest. And, hey, let's get it rolling.
Let's get it rolling. We got people tuning in, fellas.
Excellent, Smithers.
Let's see what we got. Ken Badziak.
Hey, Ken, what's up?
Matthew Walt, Jason Hoffman, Chris Hernandez, Jen Ramquist. Those are our current watches.
We love questions, so get your questions ready. We are actively monitoring for your questions. So if you have something you want us to talk about, type it on in.
I agree.
Did you boys have a good Father's Day?
Yeah. Yeah. You? What'd you do?
I actually was a little under the weather, unfortunately. I'm pulling out of it. But I was going to point out in the background here one of my Father's Day gifts. I'm up in the game here, fellas, on Nightcap. I don't know if you jealous yet or
back there. I see some alcohol that's glistening and shining. I see some letter B that's glowing, and I see a robe.
I thought that alcohol glistening was just in my head. So that's good. I'm glad it's happening in real life.
Is that like makes your me feel better? Cape? I think he's like a superhero. What's that? What's that bat cape back there? That red bat cape.
Yeah, it's the nightcap robe. We don't wear it very much anymore. My wife thought it'd be nice if it was at least in the picture, right? And then I got a decanter. I'm 45 now, right? I'm graduating to more sophisticated things. I have a decanter for my whiskey.
Can't decant.
There it is.
Ooh.
I'm wearing mine on the inside of my sweatshirt. You just don't know.
We gotta get Forbes one of these.
Yeah, what the hell?
They don't make him his size. I've looked.
Oh, that hurts, Daddy, when you talk like that.
Extra cool. They make extra cool. They do
make extra cool. It comes in size Forbes.
So here's a cool thing on Ecamm. Now it shows, next to the comments, it shows the picture of the people that are leaving the comments, which is kind of cool.
I want to leave a comment now. How do I do this? I want my picture.
Chris Hernandez says, hey, guys, it just so happens that a bunch of people on this that are watching right now have had a good week in the land business. We have some wins to celebrate.
Let's hear it.
Excellent. What do we got?
Chris Hernandez, I believe, had his first sale this last week, or two sales, I think. And he's in flight school right now, and you guys are never going to guess where he sold this property.
Your mom's
house. You talk about what platform or where it's located?
The platform.
I thought you were talking county.
You're not going to say like TikTok or something, are you?
Yeah, he sold it on TikTok. First one, no, not TikTok. But he's the first one I've ever heard of selling a property on this platform.
Zillow?
No, not Zillow. Many of us have sold property on Zillow.
Instagram?
Instagram. Not your mom's house, just to be clear.
Not my mom's house.
Not your mom's house. Okay. Redfin?
Not Redfin.
Whoa.
The MLS?
Flexing me.
We're going to let everybody else guess. See if everybody else can guess where he sold this property. You guys throw it up there where you think he might have sold it.
Hotdogs.com? I don't know.
There you go. Landon Haycock is watching. He's had sales in the last week. Steve and Tancha Hokanson are watching. They've had sales in the last week. It's happening for a lot of people. Matthew Walt, he's going to sell property before next week or he owes me a bourbon. We've already talked about that. And Jen Ramquist, it's I'm telling you, it's coming. It's right. I feel it. So anyway, there's lots of good stuff going on. You guys, did you have some wins this week as well?
I got, let me find the number, but I got paid by a guy that got COVID. Ooh. And he'd already stopped paying. And then I was like about to kick him to the curb. And I like him. And then he got COVID and I was like, all right, so now I can't take it back. And he owed me over $1,000 and he paid $500 2 weeks ago and he paid me like the other $615 or $20 today. So I don't know if that counts as a win, but I was.
Hey, you've got money in your bank account. You tell me that's not a win?
No, it's a huge win. Like, I'm glad that he gets to keep the property. Like, I felt really, really bad. Like, he was in the hospital and everything. So it was great.
You worked with him. Now, did you make him produce a doctor's note? Like, how strict were you?
No, I've been so busy between work and then running. I
need to see the doctor's note along with this late payment.
He was so late that he never hooked up a bank account to GeekPay. So he was always on a credit card, which is definitely a no-no. He's the one guy that I do it with. He was so late that GeekPay kicked him out like automatically. Like, I honestly don't even know what to do. Like, I got to go in and either start a new loan or beg someone to reactivate him. Like, I don't even know
just
what
have.
To do.
Just have Nyan reactivate the loan. You're all good.
I will. But I'm like, it's been that long that GeekPay kicked you out. Like, it's gotta go a while for that. So yeah, that was a win. That was my win.
We got more wins pouring in. We got more watchers. Lawrence Berry says hello. Mark Livingston. Don Perez is here. Steve Foster sold two properties last week. Somebody started flight school yesterday, sold two properties last week and two more today. I'm wondering if that's maybe Bill Dickens. Lots of good stuff happening.
Can we get the details? Is it
everybody,
ask? Would you buy it for? Would you sell it for? Like, come on.
Yeah, throw up some numbers.
I'm all excited over here. Come on.
Throw up some numbers and then I will divulge where Chris Hernandez sold his property. And it was guessed by Ken Badziak, but I don't think it was a true guess because I think Ken knew. He sold it on the app OfferUp.
Wow. Note taken.
Note taken. OfferUp. It's been around for a while. I've gotten a few leads on OfferUp, but I haven't used it as a serious marketing platform. But Chris Hernandez is the man, so we might be following in his footsteps.
Very interesting, Chris. Okay. Maybe he'll be a guest next week and talk all about it. That'd be good.
That would be good. So, as always, we love questions. Throw up the questions in the group, in the chat. And
questions, comments, topics for discussion.
We put a little teaser out there today for a topic, right? We thought we'd talk at least for a few minutes about something that seems to be a common theme sometimes. And I put in the group today that we were going to talk about, well, the title was Forget Your CRM, Let's Get Back to the Basics. So, Mike, you and I were talking about this week. We were talking about it with Scott Todd as well. There are a lot of things in this business, right, that distract us from the nuts and bolts. And where do we make the money? The nuts and bolts, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So This is just our reminder to everybody out there. Maybe you're just starting this. Maybe you've been in it a while and you've hit a slump or something. But it seems to me that whenever I've been in a dip, I got to sit down and have a conversation with myself and say, hey, what's going on? Well, you know what? We need to get back to the basics here. We need to do the two things that matter the most in this business, the mailing and the marketing. It's that drinking, simple.
Yeah.
Drinking and smoking.
Yep, it is because, you know, I think what everybody sort of hears when they listen to us, one of the things they hear is the beautiful part of the business that it can be outsourced. So we're talking efficiency, but we can never forget what comes first, which is the effectiveness. So if we try to jump over effectiveness into efficiency, it's a dangerous move, right? So because we haven't put together that solid puzzle first, right? That all the pieces aren't in play. And now we're trying to, well, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to outsource something. You know, there could be somebody that's even, you know what? I'm going to post some ads as an example when I get someone who's going to do it for me. But wait a minute, no, you need to start posting them yourself first. You need to get effective before you cross over to that efficiency. So we were talking about forget your CRM. Well, of course you need a CRM, but don't forget the basics. The fact that if someone's interested in a property and you follow up with them, all this stuff, everything we do from that beyond that is all about making it better, making it more efficient. But you have to start out with that, right? But we got to start out with that core set of actions that you do yourself. And then you slowly start outsourcing them.
Yeah. You know, I think back to when we started 5 years ago, Zano, and how I think it was a blessing and a curse because it was a little bit simpler time then. And we weren't as distracted by all of the new gadgets and gizmos and CRMs and tools and this land course and this land course and this land course. All we could do was focus on the fundamentals. And I didn't have a CRM for the first 3 years in this business. I had a notebook next to my computer that said hot up at the top, and I kept track of hot leads, and that's what I did. And I mean, Forbes, you got to have some input here, right? Like,
but it worked, right? Look, everybody who goes out and they're like, I'm going to go set this whole thing up and then I'm going to go buy and sell land, they're scared of buying and selling land. You're scared. Admit it. Or tell me I'm wrong, because I'm wrong like all the time. But my guess is you're scared. You want to get it all perfect. Like, it can't be perfect if you haven't done it, right? You don't know how to ride a bike until you get on the damn bike. And the bike is buying and selling land. It's not a CRM. It's not traveling mailbox. It's not this. It's not that. It is mailing and marketing. Go buy some land and sell it. And then when you're making some money, then go do a CRM. Open up a free Airtable. Use a Kanban view and have different stages. Dead, working, nurture, hot. And my all-time favorite for my sales manager, super duper hot. And that's it. And you just click on it and you're like, oh, that guy's dead to me. And you go, whoop, and you move him over here. That's it. That's all you knew. That's your CRM. Because otherwise, it's a crutch for you not actually doing this business. Soapbox.
I love it.
Over.
And you know how I know you're telling the truth? And you're spitting the truth over there? Because look at that mic stand. Oh. Look at that mic. There's
No way he'd be lying with that mic stand. I waited. I bought it all at the same time. And it was on back order forever. So I had to buy another one just so that I could actually use this microphone. But now this is my real one and it's slick and I'm very happy.
So what's the extra mic on the side? Is that another little mic? Like, it looks like there's a mic on the side with the coil wrapping around it.
No, so the microphone, so in this one, the microphone goes into the, it like goes into the actual thing, so there's no wire, and then it comes out at the bottom and then goes into.
But that piece right there, is it another microphone though? That looks like a little microphone on right next to it, above it. Yes,
on the bar.
No, this is the microphone core. This is like the cord to the microphone.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah. It looks like it was maybe another part of it. That's pretty amazing.
Yes, I'm quite happy.
He's an AV, AV guy. Mark should Forbes be is an AV guy. You know.
Well, Mark has the same thing, doesn't he?
No, because I ended up upgrading my microphone arm, so he has the crappy version of this, and I have
so you told him to order one, and then you ordered another one.
I called him. I called him back and was like, "Hey, just so you know, since they're all out of stock, anyways, I upgraded to this other version so that the mic wire isn't hanging and dangling." And he's like, "Yeah, I don't care." And I'm like, "Whatever. Okay, fine. I never liked you, anyways, Podolsky."
Hey, we got people throwing up numbers here. Steve Foster, for his two sales, he bought for $415 each and sold on terms $99 a month for 24 months. That's a sweet deal. Florida Panhandle deal.
Nice.
Mark Livingston threw up some numbers here. He said bought for $1,100, sold today for $99 a month for 72 months in Florida. Beautiful deal.
That's a good deal.
Does not suck.
Beautiful deal. And I assume there's a dock fee on that, Livingston, so your money's out in probably nine or 10 months.
That ROI is insane.
It's insane.
He's an accountant. Tell us the yield, Mark. Come on, tell us the yield on that. That's crazy.
We're going to get into yield. We have to talk about yield.
Well, it's Mark Livingston. I know he knows this. He's got the ROI and the yield. 99 down, 72 a month, bought for 1,100. I want to know. Let's hear it, Mark.
Racine says, Racine, the land deal machine says, nice sweater, Forbes. Yeah.
Is he got a sweater on?
It's a sweater.
Kind of like my old beat up sweatshirt that.
Is there going to be football this year?
Yeah! There's going to be football.
Is there going to be football?
Well, there's going to be baseball. 60 games of baseball, so.
Probably
will there be people in the stands or just football with no people?
It could be football with no fans, but I don't know how well that would work for football. I mean, I'm sure they're going to try it, but I think we're going to get a pretty big bump. Kids go back to school, we're going to get a bigger bump, and, you know. It's going to be weird for a while, everybody. Sit tight. Sell some land.
This is going to be weird for a while. Mark Livingston said his annual yield, Mike. Any guesses? Any guesses on Mark Livingston's annual yield on that deal?
What's the annual yield? Oh, now he's throwing me off. No, I don't want to guess.
Over 100%.
Oh, I'd like to talk about his down payment of $39.
Yeah, right?
What's up with that down payment?
Well, how'd you know that? Where'd you get that? I didn't see those numbers.
Yeah, he threw it up here. Down payment of $39.
I think it's creative. Of 100%,
I think it's
though,
creative.
That's stupid. That is stupid. I mean, think about that. $1,100 and he's going to go make over $7,000? I mean, are you kidding me?
The numbers in this business just still amaze me, right? It's just staggering. You sit down and think about it. It's absolutely staggering.
It is staggering.
I had a win today. Four years ago, I bought a property in a POA. I know, Scott Todd, don't shoot me. But I bought a property in POA. I sold it on terms, and the POA fees are high, and you know, you get behind on one or two payments, they kill you with late fees, right? So the guy that's buying the property from me today, he paid it off. I opened my email, $3,600, paid it off. Now I get rid of the property. We're rid of the POA headache. Everything's gone. So
that's why you listen to Scott Todd and don't go buy property in a POA.
But today it paid off.
Awesome. Yeah, it did pay off. Yeah.
So anyway, so that was my win for the day. Not only did I get a lot paid off, but I'm getting rid of this POA that I never want to work in again. What is a POA? POA is a property owners association.
Oh, yeah. But, you know, so I work in an area that has a POA, $54 a year.
Right.
And I'm like, excuse me? And the woman's like, yeah, it comes with the boat ramp and you know, access to the 9-hole golf course. And I'm like, I bet that's a sweet golf course, hon. That sounds terrific. $54. Don't care at all. Moving on. Right? And you know what's amazing? It's $54 and I buy these properties for whatever, $200, $300, $400, and there's still another $200 in packed, you know, POA dues. And you're like, you got to be kidding me.
Nobody likes to pay those POA fees.
No, you pay them at the end. Don't worry about it. But yeah, not a great place to start. You don't want.
You don't.
You shouldn't be looking for those.
Yeah, you don't pay them at the end though. When there's a monthly late fee and the fees are, you know, $500 a year or more. So everybody, when you're doing your due diligence on areas to buy property and areas to sell property, POAs, they can be a deal breaker for sure.
Scott, I wonder if we have anybody out there that just started flight school last night. Anybody want to chime in? Because we had a brand new class start last night. And anybody out there watching us, let us know how your first class went.
Andrew Hanley.
Haney, I think. Yeah, yes, Andrew started. There's a bunch of other people on the call that have started. Bill Dickens started. Let's see who else. Why does Siri keep going off? She's driving me crazy. So we have a question here. Let me find it again.
All right.
True story.
Why don't more people know about the business of land investing? Compared to everything else I've tried, this seems like the perfect business. Forbesy.
Yes.
Let me call on you.
I'd like to answer that question, please. The answer is because it's so freaking boring. That's why. That is the answer. It's so boring that unfortunately some people try it and they do it and they're successful with it and they're so bored with it that they stop doing it. Go look at the reviews. You'll almost find nobody that's like, it doesn't work, right? It works. It works 100% of the time. It demonstrably works if you work it. I mean, I think any passive model, you have to work it. But unlike going out and spending 9 months researching the perfect apartment building and buying a 72-unit multifamily where you get that huge general adrenaline rush and then you've got all this work to do and you're killing it, that is not this business, right? This is like, what was my win for the week? I got a text that says I made $600 that I didn't know was coming. Like, that was my win for today, right? It's not sexy. It's boring. It's raw land somewhere. And that's what makes it so good. You know it works. If you just stick with it, you'll be one of the few that does really, really well if you just work it. That's why I came to the business. I found this model and I said, this is great. It demonstrably works. And then lots of people quit because it's too boring. I can not get bored. That sounds great. I can outwork people. I can outlast people. I can do this. And that's why I chose this business. So, yeah, that is, I swear, that's the answer. Zeno, what do you think? Am I off base?
No, I don't think you're off base at all. I think, you know, they're not going to find a lot of shows about this, not a lot of exposure to this. People that find this are doing some sort of deep internet search, and they hear about it on some sort of, you know, podcast, or someone talks about it and they investigate it. So I just don't think it's very it's just not out there. It's not in the limelight. It's just not there. You have to search for it.
Well, and it's, you know, and to be fair too, like, it's hard, right? I think you look at people who are like, you look at Mark Livingston, right? And I know Mark pretty well, right? We've invested on some properties together. I've met him, I don't know, a half dozen times. I've been out to dinner with him probably 7 or 8 or 9 or 10 times at this point in boot camps, right? You know, like, super smart guy, but it's not like you enter the land business and 8 minutes later, you've bought a property for $1,100 and you sold it for $7,000. Now, the people in flight school are a little bit different because they're getting that direct mandated coaching where they are going to go do those things, right? But for the average person out there who wants to go do it themselves, it takes a little while to go buy property. Then you got to figure out marketing and then you got to go sell it. And, like, you know, it's simple in concept, but it's hard work doing this business. You got to work at it every day. And most people don't. Most people just, I think they just quit, even though they've had some success. You know, the key is you got to just stick with it. So go do it, people.
Go do it, people. Rinse and repeat.
I feel like I'm ranting a lot. I need
You are ranting. You're angry tonight, Forbes. Why are you angry today?
I'm going to
tell you. Jealous of my decanter?
No. It's because my wife made me watch. But the Netflix thing on the whole USA Gymnastics debacle.
I watched it today, dude. Guy.
Yeah, USA, Team USAA or whatever.
Athlete A.
Oh, my. I want to drive to the prison and just shoot that guy in the head. And so wow. I'm all bitter and angry about it. Yeah, no, I'm super fired up. So I'll go on mute. That's what I'll do.
Okay. All right. No, that's a powerful story. And yeah, that's it's very unfortunate, all that stuff would happen. But to go a little lighter, I'm going to go take it lighter now, okay? Lawrence Berry just sold his first property.
Lawrence Berry!
Paid $300 for the property and sold for $3,000 cash.
Yeah, baby!
I love it.
What?
That is awesome. That is awesome.
That's a crazy ROI, right?
That's great.
Yes.
Lawrence Berry, congratulations. That's amazing. Now time to rinse and repeat. First sales artist. More will come. Flight school was great last night. Learned so much in just the first class. Jason Hoffman said, I had a blast in the first session last night. Loves the pricing matrix. I've been busy poking around for counties. Yeah, you better show up with a county to call too, Jason, or Scott Todd's going to be there with the mini bat. I don't think he uses the mini bat anymore in flight school.
No?
I don't know. Does he?
I don't know.
He did when I was in flight school.
Well, that was ages ago, Forbes. Ages.
It was, yeah. It's
sad. Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Any other questions, Land Geek Nation? While you guys are coming up with questions, talk amongst yourselves. I'm going to go over to my decanter and refill.
Oh, is it the refill session?
Well, I mean, I need a refill, so are you ready?
I'm ready. Have a drink. You guys need to do a toast. I don't even have a cocktail.
Too angry. You don't even have a cocktail. It's nightcap. I know. You know what? Austin Powers, down the chute. Here you go. You ready? See ya. See ya, Forbes. Bye.
You can't.
Bye.
What?
No, I thought you were like ejecting him. I'm like, what's going on here?
I did eject him. He's gone.
No.
He's not gone. Zato, you get all nervous. You think that little of me?
That's because I'd hang up on you again and go to bed.
You think that little of me, Zato.
Brutal.
That's come on. Seriously.
We got no more questions? This is sad.
I didn't say Siri, I said seriously.
Yes, Siri. You stink.
You guys are quiet.
I'm doing a new drawing on my new thing here.
Drawing!
The show.
We love drawings.
I'm basically, I'm taking the highlights of the show and putting them on my new Fluid Stance board, and then I'll reveal at the end of the show as a recap.
Oh, nice!
I know you're not really in favor of my Fluid Stance.
But I love how you tried to emulate my... Because I have a board in front of my computer. With the, little mini whiteboard, and I think it's sweet that you're, taking after me. What do we got here? Oh, Mike Newble says no more bat for Scott Todd. So the mini bat's gone, I guess. I don't know. Maybe it was. Maybe it came across as too mean. Matt Waltz says. Some folks needed a mini bat in our March class. Yes. Yes. Oh, Matt Walt, you're a funny guy. What's working now in the marketing world? Matt and I got frustrated when the rules changed with Craigslist and the auto poster programs, etc. What is working now in the marketing world? That's a good question.
Fellas, what was the other part of it? What's going on in the marketing world? But he said,
Matt and I got and this is Facebook user. It doesn't have a name. But Matt and I got frustrated with the rules when the rules changed with Craigslist and the auto poster programs. So what's worked, I guess the bottom line is, what's working for everyone now with marketing and sales?
Posting ads.
Consistency. Are you looking for a platform? Is that what this
numbers?
Because I'm thinking.
No. Yeah. I mean, that's exactly right. It's all about numbers, right? It's all about consistency. It's all about posting more than you think you need to. Posting, 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 posting. And well, posting. Go ahead, Forbes.
Well, I just, you know, Mark talks about, you know, he always makes that joke, like, I'm flexible like a yogi. But you got to be pretty flexible in this business, because the second you figure it out, they change it.
Yeah.
This is the way it is. We're doing something that, like, Craigslist and Facebook and, you know, it's not like they want us to be doing these things, right? This is not their goal. So I don't think we're doing anything illegal. I mean, I know we're not doing anything illegal, but we're not in what they want to have happen. So that was Wes Schaefer who posted that, by the way. So, you know, you got to be flexible. Like, so if they change something, you got to adapt. You got to try new stuff. And you really want to be scientific about this, right? You know, go back to eighth grade science. You want to have a claim of what you think is going to work. And then you want to go test that claim and see if it actually did, in fact, work. And if it didn't, then you need to have a new claim. You need to have a new hypothesis. You got to try something else. And you just sort of keep going. You know, the people who I think are really good at this, they're constantly trying new things. And they're not all their eggs are not in one basket, right? So if they shut down the auto poster and Craigslist, you know, they're not toast, right? And I'm not saying, Wes, that's you by any stretch. But, you know, you got to have different things going so that, you know, because they don't tend to all fall apart at the same time, or at least they haven't yet. It's always like one, there's a major issue with one of them, right? Facebook did a whole thing like a month ago, and it really screwed some people up. And if Facebook was your only deal and that was how you ran your business, you know, you had a hiccup. So you're just going to go try something else and, you know, figure it out. But I do know people who are using the auto poster program with Wes, and it's still working. So,
yeah. I mean, even the auto poster program, even Posting Domination from its first inception 4 years ago, right, has changed a lot. So things just, they constantly change. And I think for us and our team, it's just a matter of showing up in multiple places a lot, right? So we're showing up here a lot. We're showing up here a lot. We're showing up here a lot. And it's all about the number of leads that you're going to get in all of those different areas. As far as platforms go, if you guys are looking for platforms, where have we sold land this year? Facebook Marketplace, Good Talk,
TikTok.
Oh, TikTok. I thought you said Good Talk. Facebook Marketplace, Craigslist, Landmodo, Zillow, Buyers List. So you think about it, we've sold properties.
Wholesale.
What's that? Wholesale. Yeah. We've sold properties in all of these areas. Now, are some platforms more prevalent than others for us? Yes, I'd say Facebook Marketplace right now is more prevalent for us.
Yeah, I would agree.
For the OfferUp platform, is that a place you want to post ads daily for one property, or would you just post once? You know what? I have no idea. So this is a new thing. Like, you know, I've known of OfferUp for a little while. We've set some ads on there. We've got some leads, but we're not necessarily taking it seriously. And then Chris Hernandez, who's in flight school right now, gets his first sale on OfferUp. Is it a new platform? New up-and-coming platform? We don't know yet. And maybe Chris has some input that he can throw in the chat there regarding, you know, how he systematically marketed on there.
Well, there was a time a few years ago where everybody was like, sell a property on Facebook? Yeah, right. I mean, it was like nobody thought that would happen, right? And then it started happening, and then it became a thing. So this offer up, who's to say?
He said he posts a couple times a week on OfferUp. So there you go. There is a companion app that is similar to it called Letgo. 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 That one.
I was just thinking that song. Wow, you're like a mind reader.
Mind reader. Oh, here's a question from Steve Fasta. Fasta. Fabia. Ready? Where is everybody on mapping software? I'm using MapRite and liking it. You can actually pull mailing lists from it. Any feedback on that, fellas? I think, Zeno, you might have some feedback on that.
I like MapRite. I think MapRite's got some good capabilities. You can define the area on multiple parcels. You can share the map with people. You can show the property lines. I think it's got some high functionality. I like MapRite. I do. But I don't think that's the only one out there. There's others out there. But I have used MapRite quite a bit.
$7 a map? Sounds aggressive.
Oh, no. You get a little simple monthly subscription. Easy peasy.
Peasy lemon squeezy.
Whoa.
Do we know if the boot camp in Vegas will be happening? So here's the good and the bad of it. The boot camp in Vegas will not be happening. However, the boot camp in virtual world will be happening. We are having virtual boot camp, I believe, for the rest of the year. So August boot camp will be virtual, and I think October boot camp will be virtual as well. And more details will be released soon.
Mark's not going to have to come to the East Coast.
Can't hear you, Zeno.
I said, no. Can you hear me now?
There, yes.
Mark's not going to have to come to the East Coast. We had Atlanta.
I know. Sad. So sad.
That was going to be a good one.
Damn you, COVID.
So damn you, COVID. Any other questions out there? Any answers out there?
Expect the same dates for virtual? Yes, Matthew Walt. The first weekend in August is when virtual boot camp is. I definitely miss boot camp. You guys miss boot camp?
A lot.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
A lot. Because you can't, you know, my friends don't want to talk about land anymore.
You know what, Forbes? You join us here every Wednesday night.
Nobody wants to hear about the money you make doing land investing. Yeah, first they don't want to hear that you're doing land investing they want to hear it because they want to be like, yeah, right, good luck with that, Matt Forbes. And then you start doing well, and they're like, we don't want to hear how you did that. We don't want to hear how you made 300% of your money. Don't tell us that. So you can't win. So no win.
You totally can't. So I love NICAP for that. I'm thankful for it. That's why I'm here every week. I miss boot camp. You know, like I get to see all the guys. I get to see Detmer and Livingston and Burnett and Land Duo and YouTube Monkeys and, you know, all the clowns. So, yeah, I miss it.
Oh, man. Here's to you, Forbes.
Forbesy.
Here's to you, buddy. We miss you, too.
Aw. We could do our own, you know, private boot camp where you just come to Massachusetts and play golf.
Yeah, I think this fall...
Wouldn't suck.
No, it wouldn't suck. I'm feeling a fall road trip, honestly.
Really?
So, yeah.
I like it.
Zeno, how's the drawing going there, buddy?
It's almost ready. I have it.
Hello. My name is Zeno.
Do drawings. Oh, yes.
Hey, everyone, today in the bathtub at Ma.
any other questions? Any other questions? Any other wins? Steve Foster says, I'll be at virtual boot camp, friends. I don't check in enough, but this community is top shelf. Steve, thanks, buddy. It was great meeting you at that boot camp in Texas, and it's a great thing about boot camp is, you know, the lasting connections you make with people, and then you get to see them over and over again. People keep coming back. It's not a one and done thing.
Not if you're serious about it, right? You just go back because every time I go, I meet new people, but I meet investors. Right. I mean, you know, you get that nugget that you really, really need. You're not ready for all the information in the beginning. You know, you have to go back and you get the thing you need every single time. because you're then ready for that information. Like, literally every time Scott Todd opens his mouth and does a presentation, I'm like, oh, harumph, I've sort of heard this before, I know this. And then I'm like, huh, I remember typing these notes. I remember him saying this, but I didn't understand it the way I understand it now. Now I'm going to go take action and change something. It happens every single time. It's like, it's sort of repetitive where I'm like, hey, I really got a lot out of that. You know, I say that to him every single boot camp. So you should go. You know, if they existed.
They will. They will exist again.
Okay.
They will. Lawrence Berry does have a question. Can I send neighbor letters with LG Pass? So at this time, I don't think that's a function of LG Pass.
But everything is updating so much on that. Scott, every time we talk to him, I feel like he has a new update. So I'm sure that's coming.
I think you could, though. Wouldn't you just? Well, I mean, I guess not. No. Yeah, no, not realistically. No.
Yeah.
Mail merge. Mail merge a letter. No problem.
Mail merge a letter. Exactly. I learned how to do it on YouTube in 2015. My 5-year anniversary is coming up here, boys. I just checked my email yesterday to see when I ordered the toolkit. I knew it was coming up. And
really?
July 3rd, 2015 was the day I ordered the toolkit. So
So here's a question.
Yeah.
When is your start date? I believe your start date is the day you sell your first property.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Well, for me, the start date was the day I ordered that thing because I was so motivated to change my life. I heard Mark on a podcast on July 2nd, honestly, and I ordered that thing on July 3rd, and I was ready to take action. And with the toolkit, you need to take massive action if you want to start buying and selling land with the toolkit. Like, you got to dedicate a ton of time to it just because it's harder. You're alone. There's no scheduled execution. It's a DIY program, you know.
Yeah.
DIY programs, the percentage of success is quite low. But I was very motivated to change my life. And for me, Forbes, it happened as soon as I got that thing because as soon as I got that thing, I went through it once. I went through it again. And I don't know. For me, that's where everything changed. Because I started taking massive action right when I got it. Now, there was a phase two with that when I bought my first property for $700 at week 6 and sold it for $2,800 at week 8. And, I mean, that's crazy proof of concept, right?
Yeah, that's crazy.
So, but to think of how my life has changed in 5 years, I mean, it's absolutely... I've been very reflective here in the last day since I looked at that email. Like, look at what has happened because of that one decision my wife and I made to order the toolkit. And I don't know. I mean, I replaced my income. I quit my job. I made amazing lifelong friends. I made business connections. I mean, it's... I can't say enough about it.
It's crazy to think how there's that one moment where it all turns, right? You hear something, and I think it starts there. I mean, before the purchase, in my mind, it's like when this thought emerges in your mind, this is when it all begins. You know, that may not be an investor yet, but this is it. This is the pivot point at that moment. You heard about it. Someone says, hey, ever hear about raw land investing? Or you hear a podcast, or you happen across something. At that moment, it's like click, something happens. That's the turning point.
I'm going through my old email. I want to know.
I want to see if I can remember Forbes. Let's see. I'm going to say January of 2018 is when I met you. So I'm going to say... You didn't get the toolkit first.
I didn't. No, the toolkit would just be a waste of money for me.
Yeah, so you were December 2017 flight school. That's my guess. Let's see here. We got some comments. Katie Juno, we've closed 2 deals this month. with $800 a piece for 5 years? What does that, Katie, what does that mean? Does that mean you're getting, does that mean you have $1,600 a month passive income for 5 years? Please verify what that means, because it sounds awesome. Mike Newbel, I got my first accepted offer letter back. Should I call them or do everything by email? That's a great question. Mike Newbel.
Well, if he gave you his phone number, you know, I know a lot of people get a little a lot of people do get nervous with thinking, oh my gosh, what am I going to do? I got to call someone. But I think it's a great experience. I think you just have to be authentic, Mike. I think you should call them if you have the number and just talk to them and let them know that you're a real person. Let them know that you're authentic. Just be very relaxed and don't think you have to sound like you've been doing this for a million years. You might even be very transparent and say, this is my first ever land purchase and I'm excited about it. I'd love to work with you. I want this to be positive for both of us. So, you know, embrace it. Embrace it. Call that person. Get out of your comfort zone.
And you know what I would say to that, Mike Newbel, is I've talked to you on the phone multiple times, and I would say that those were enjoyable conversations. So I anticipate that if you call that person, they're going to feel the same way. Give them a ring, make an authentic connection, have a meaningful conversation with that person. You may just be surprised at how they respond. And I've had some really rewarding conversations in my life with people that I'm buying land from. And I just saw an example this week in the Facebook group. Who was it? Somebody posted. Oh, it was Brad Donzie. Brad Donzie rhymes with Fonzie. He posted a picture of a thank you letter that someone had written him for buying their land. And I still have my first thank you letter over here from this lady named Dell. She's the lady I bought my first property from. Sent me a thank you letter. And I thought that left a huge impression on me. But we talked on the phone a lot of times I don't know, Mike. I think like Zano said, you give him a call and you both talk through this and go at it.
I love it.
Somebody says email is the easy way out. I mean, you could say that. I have bought land by email.
Yeah, you could just set up a nice template response, and of course. But I think it's empowering to have that conversation. And that's why I encourage it. Not to say that I agree, whoever wrote that, yes, email is the easy way out, it can work, but step out on a limb, have a nice conversation. You'll make a new friend, you'll buy some land, you'll make a whole bunch of money. Not a bad day.
Not a bad day.
I think you got to call him. I'll be that guy. I'll tell you that you got to call him. Like, this business is about getting out of your comfort zone.
If they gave you the number, right, Matt? Now, if they didn't give you the number, but if they gave you the number, they're looking for a phone call. You know,
right.
They gave you
the
number.
And honestly, look, at some point, you're getting on the phone with these people, right? And what you're going to find out, it's like talking to your aunt you haven't talked to in 35 years, right? Number one, they talk too much. It is what it is, right? They have a story. You just got to be there to listen to it. That's how you're, going to negotiate them down a little bit. That's how you're going to learn things about the property, and that's how you're going to learn the business. So I think the other two guys on this podcast are being awfully sweet and nice. I won't be. Get on the phone. Call them. It'll be fine.
You're a funny guy. To clarify, Katie Juno says, this is right, boys. She two deals, $800 a month each for 5 years. She
$1,600 out of the gate.
$1,600 a month for 5 years on two properties. Holy buckets!
Yeah, I want to know what you paid for them. Those are great.
What did you pay for them, Katie?
Yeah,
that's amazing. Congrats to you. That's a life-changing deal. Yeah. And how many hours did it take you to make that life-changing deal? Right? It's all about taking a chance, making a commitment, and doing a few hours of work.
Those are good numbers.
Do you ever have owners that get... Oh, Zano, this goes back to the... We've had a couple nightcaps on this subject. Do you ever have owners that get offended by the lowball offer? Oh, no. Sorry. Different subject. Do you ever have owners that get offended by the lowball offer go onto your LinkedIn or Facebook and call you out in public? One of my irrational fears. Well, that's a good question. No, never. But it's never happened.
It's a real question, but I've never seen it happen. I think the most they're going to do is, I would say the people, how do I say this? The people that tend to write you these long letters and all that, I don't see them really being Facebookers. I don't think they're going to be the kind of people that are looking for you on Facebook. They seem to be not the Facebook type. I'll say that. I think they're gonna write a long letter to you, or they're going to call you out on a voicemail, and that's the end of it. And you just have to realize that, you know, 3 to 5% respond. They're looking to sell. That leaves a whole bunch of people, 95%, that are either just indifferent or upset. And that's just part of it. And it's not, you know, we do a lot of times here joke about these people and the letters we get, but it's not, we're not making fun of them. We're just trying to make light of the fact that, you know, we have to deal with it. But it's just, it's not for everyone. There's certain people that, just will get offended by it. Some people will just don't even care, don't even want to respond. Some people won't open the letter, but 3 to 5% will. They'll want to sell. 1% will be worth closing on. Just keep hitting it.
Yeah,
don't worry about that. No one's going on your Facebook.
I think you make it sound, first of all, it's never happened on Facebook, and it would be hilarious if somebody ever looked me up on LinkedIn. I've never had a LinkedIn. And I'm pretty big on LinkedIn.
I'm
kind of a big deal, okay? No, not at all, for the record, not at all. I'm not Wes Schaefer, God's sake. But those worlds never collide, right, ever. But, you know, but Zeno may have just given you a weird feeling, right? Because he's like, look, 3 to 5% respond, and you deal with them, or, you know, you buy 1% or whatever it is, and, you know, and then the rest, some are mad and some aren't. Those are not the statistics. 3 to 5% respond, right? And that leaves literally 95 to 97% who don't, right? So, and there's sub 1% who will send you an email. There's one half of that number that might go leave you a nasty voicemail.
Yeah, I made it look worse than it could be. You're right. I could have painted it like in a little way to look bigger.
I had one guy call me many times. Like 3-4 times, right? And leave me like the nasty, you know, RingCentral. And so I finally picked up once and I'm like, I don't even have to deal with that. I have an intake guy, right? That's his problem, not mine. And we talked for like 30 minutes. And at the end of 30 minutes, he went from, you know, I'm going to call the governor. And I'm like, first of all, I'm not doing anything illegal. Like, you're an idiot, right? But we went through it. And by the end of the phone call, he was like, thank you so much. Now I understand. I just didn't get why I was getting letters from you, and I'd gotten a couple of others, and, you know, I thought you were doing something completely different. And I'm like, so do you want to sell me the land? He's like, absolutely not. And I'm like, yeah, I wouldn't sell me the land either. So have a great day. Bye. That's the worst conversation I've had in this business the whole time. Not because wasn't enjoyable. It was enjoyable. It lasted 30 minutes.
Right? Yeah. But people will, they will come around. If you talk to them, they want someone to argue with them. When you don't argue with them, and you just basically it's like it takes the power away, and then it's like they have nothing left to do but just talk to you. And beautifully, well done, Matt.
I've had two instances in the last 5 years where someone has said to me after I send them an offer letter, "Hey, I found your website," and the one lady said to me, "Hey, I found your website. That's a really nice looking website. I would love to sell you my property." Oh, and that was it. And the other guy said, "Hey, I found your website. I see you're selling these for this amount. I'm not selling my property to you." So two instances, which I thought, sorry, Siri, what the heck? Siri's driving me crazy tonight. Yeah. Anyway, so it does not happen often.
Is it time to reveal the highlights of the show?
What's that?
I look forward to this call.
Is it time to reveal the highlights of the show?
Let's reveal the highlights of the show and then
do drawings.
Here we are. Ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
Florida, Florida, Florida.
Can you see this? And I'll explain. So number one, can you see over here? Offer up. You've learned tonight that that's a possible new. We're going to explore that. Remember, Facebook wasn't huge back in the day. This is the next thing that could be coming. Could be coming. Number two, CRM. Guys, giving it a karate kick. That all that refers to is don't get caught up in all this other stuff until you're being effective. Like, you need a CRM, yes. But what we're saying is don't forget the mailing and marketing. Don't forget the basics. Don't forget the fundamentals. Over here, who do we have here with the big microphone? Matt Forbes. See that?
Yeah.
How about you? Yeah. I'm not making fun of you. I'm looking underneath here. What's it say?
Consistency. No one can read that. Okay.
It says consistency. You are an example of consistency. You've been on here. You're honest. You're straightforward. You've had some times you wouldn't be making sales, right? But you kept going. You're doing an incredible job in the business, and I think you gave everybody hope. And thank you for coming on. But the highlight. Go ahead. You can say something.
Right. I'm also like the slowest growing guy of all time. I'm the slow and steady wins the race. I'm a turtle.
Boss, but doesn't he give hope? The guy's consistent. He puts the work in, and he gets results.
Yeah, he's totally consistent. And
do you know what the highlight of the night is? We've had some great numbers out there. The last one with 800, but I mean, that's incredible. But this one sale made the night for me because we've been working with him for a long time. Lawrence Berry, 3K.
Yeah, baby. Yes.
All of you who made sales, I am not saying that your sales, they were all incredible. We had Mark Lipkins, incredible, over 100% yield. We had, who was the last woman who said that two $800 ones?
Katie Juno.
Yeah, incredible. But Lawrence Berry, up in New England, in the state of Maine, we made a 3K sale.
Boom.
Way to go, Lawrence Berry. I think that is incredible. Sorry, I had to do that.
Zayla,
I said stop yelling.
I love the recap. I love the recap. Sorry.
That's the recap.
All right, boys. Well, another episode has come and gone. You know, we've been doing this a while. Go back and watch our old episodes. There's I mean, you know, there's some good content here and there. There's some singing here and there.
Another show of singing. When's that happening? We're ready.
You know what? I can't even find Nightcap the Musical online anymore. If anybody can find Nightcap the Musical online.
Damn shame. Harumph.
It was May 1st, 2018, and I'm having a hard time finding it. So I don't know if maybe Facebook didn't like all of the, I don't know, the music, and they kicked us off or what.
I think we need to, you know, it's COVID, there's no boot camp. We need to lighten things up. We need to bring back a musical.
Yeah, you might be right, dude.
And Forbes is going to sing.
Yeah.
I don't sing in public.
You sang the 12 Days of Christmas Lame Geek style. That was incredible.
Yeah, that was like a 30-minute presentation.
Yeah, I don't think we need to talk about
it. All right, so anyway, it's coming. Nightcap the Musical 3 is coming.
Nobody wants to see that.
I think a lot of people, throw it up in the comments. I think a lot of people may like to see Nightcap the Musical 3.
Let's do a survey in the group. We'll say who would like us to bring back a third musical. I think we could probably get Mark to sing on this one. I have a feeling.
Okay, I'll go. I'll show up. If Mark is singing, that sounds legitimate. I'm in.
Oh, there we go. That's the turning point. We need Mark to sing a song.
Yeah. I didn't say I'd sing. I just said I'd show up to the day.
I think I think Mark would love to be on Nightcap Musical 3.
I think so too.
What do you think, Scott?
No question. I think he would. Yeah, he at a moment's notice would do that for sure.
Only one person would probably want to do it more, and that'd be Eric Peterson.
Right, with his guitar.
I would kill to see Eric Peterson.
I'm just kidding, Eric. I know that you wouldn't want to sing on a nightcap, but it's just...
Yeah, I think he would. I feel good about it. I feel like I can speak play, for Peterson.
He could play the guitar while Mark sings.
Yeah.
The guitar. I'm in. All right, boys. I'm going to bed.
Well, That sounds good.
Thank you, fellas. We'll talk soon.
Great job, guys.
Night, everybody.
Bye.